A burning question many investors have, is the stock market in a bubble today? I think it's a fantastic question. Shows you that you have your mind in the right spot. I'm going to talk about the stock market. Look at its history. We can learn a lot of things from history. So we'll look at some of the biggest examples of stock market bubbles in the United States. I'll show you a simple ratio that will help identify if the stock market is in a bubble. We'll compare and look at the history of that ratio compared to these examples we'll talk about in the video. The ratio is not perfect. No ratio will be, but this can help give you context. And I'll also discuss how can we use this information and what should we do with it? You know, if we believe that the stock market is in a bubble, should we go 100% cash? How should we act? So I'll cover all of that in this video. First, let's talk about some of the examples. The obvious one is the Great Depression, right? Everybody thinks about that one. The way it started is the 1920s were really prosperous for the United States economy. A bunch of new technologies came out. So, you know, this idea of new technology and innovation is not new. It's happened over and over and over again. So instead of like today's world, we think of the internet and social media as the newest groundbreaking technologies. Back then, the radio, the automobile, airplanes, those all became commercialized and all were huge, huge innovations of that time. A lot of Americans were borrowing money, investing with margin. And so it really pushed the market up. They called it the Roaring Twenties. And so up until what they call Black Tuesday, and it's referred to as the stock market crash of 1929. Up until then, the market was going really strong. And then Black Tuesday hit. The market really took a tumble and it took it a long time to recover. So that kind of started the Great Depression. From its high to its low, the S&P 500 went from 31.86 to 4.4. So you're looking at a loss of 86.1%. It took 34 months for it to recover. And so this was an obvious, huge kind of stock market bubble that really hurt a lot of investors. And so it really was that first big example in the US of the dangers of buying stocks with high valuations. The second bubble that was really huge, the dot-com bubble, the late 1990s, companies were coming out, all these tech stocks, internet stocks, they would even add dot-com to their name and see their stock price soar. Just a lot of huge valuations, people were making fortunes overnight. Basically what happened from early 2000 to 2002, the NASDAQ, which is the tech company, tech stock index, plunged from 5,000 to nearly 1,000. The bubble popped, just like every other bubble. And these businesses that didn't have earnings and had really crazy high valuations eventually returned to normal values. The last one I'll talk about is the kind of too big to fail bubble, the housing bubble that really, really boiled over by 2008. Bear Stearns, Lehman Brothers failed. A lot of the too big to fail banks failed. There were a lot of bailouts that happened. The S&P 500 went from 1565 to 682, a loss of over 50%. Basically, a 17-month bear market followed that bubble. Now, what I'll talk about next is a ratio that you can use. It can help give context to looking at the current valuation of the stock market. And if it's obviously in a bubble, then this ratio will tend to be high. What I'm talking about is the Shiller PE ratio. It's also known as the cap ratio, CAPE. I guess you would pronounce it cape. They also call it the PE10. So basically what that does, it looks at the earnings over the last 10 years of the market, adjusts them for inflation, and displays that as a price to earnings ratio in contrast to a regular S&P price to earnings ratio, which just use the previous year's earnings. So if we look at the chart of the Shiller PE ratio, you can look at like the late 1929s, all the way up to Black Tuesday, the Shiller PE shot up to 30, but what we saw was just a huge increase from a range of like 5 to 7 all the way up to 20, 25, 30. Huge increase in the Shiller PE ratio. That huge increase, very steep, can be characteristic of a bubble. Same thing happened with the dot-com bubble. Basically 1990s and the later you went towards the late 90s, the steeper the increase. So we went from a 25, 30, 35, 40, almost hit the peak of 45. And if you look at the 2008, the housing bubble, the stock market bubble that was kind of accompanied with that, saw a PE ratio, Shiller PE, of above 25 for several years. Now, that might not seem terribly high, but the mean Shiller PE historically since the late 1800s has been 16.85. So what can we do with this information? Does this mean that anytime the Shiller PE for the stock market is above a 17, does that mean we should be 100% cash? I think absolutely not. What I think is the Shiller PE can be a helpful tool. It can be an identifier, especially if you see it sharply increase. It can be an identifier that the market is approaching bubble territory. But I don't believe it should be something that you particularly want to adjust your cash balance just because of it. Like, I don't think you should be selling out of stocks automatically because you fear that it's in the bubble and you fear a crash and you want to get out. What I've found and what a lot of people have found when it comes to prudent investing, long-term investing, making gains, letting companies compound money for you over the long term, time in the market beats timing the market. And so you could even be an investor who invests in the absolutely worst times. You could invest at the peaks. But if you're investing for decades, as you should, you know, investing is a lifelong thing. You should be investing for decades. If you are, you're holding, you're going through the bubbles as they pop, as the recoveries happen, bear and bull markets, you'll be fine and you'll outperform rather than if you try to jump in and out of the market. While it's a good question to ask, it's good to understand, to have context on where the market is. If the market's in bubble territory or approaching it, then you need to be very, very careful with the stocks you're picking. But I think it should be obvious that you want to avoid the stocks that are most bubble-like in their characteristics, the ones with the highest valuations, highest price earnings ratios, highest price to book, price to sales. The How to Analyze Stocks Using Valuations playlist can help you find great businesses trading at great prices, ones with low valuations rather than high valuations. Basically, those are going to be the ones that are less likely to crash like a bubble stock would. Also, be sure to subscribe to the channel. Hit like if you enjoyed this video. Thanks. Stop working for money. Put money to work for you. I will talk to you next time.